Hello, everybody. This is Sylvain Philippe. I'm glad to be with you today. I'm Sylvain Philippe. I'm the pre-sales team manager for AV Simulation. And today I'm with Julien Faeda. And we will talk about the vehicle in the loop with a scanner software product of AV Simulation. Julien Faeda, if you want to introduce yourself.
So I'm Julien Faeda. I'm a sales manager of Rotronics. French company delivering dynos since 1991. And we will introduce with Sylvain Philippe the dyno together with the simulation software.
Thank you, Julien. So the goal of our presentation today will be to have an overview of the scanner in the loop testing solutions that we can offer you. We will then focus on Rotronics solutions for vehicle in the loop testing that will be mainly led by Julien today. We will discuss about some project we had together with AV Simulation, Scanner and Rotronics. And we have a part for questions answer. So if you have any questions answer, please feel free to ask your questions to the chat of this event. Please put your name when you put a question. Don't ask your question in anonymous. Otherwise, we may have some delay to answer to you. And if we don't have enough time to get back to you about your questions, don't be afraid. We will get back to you following this web event to make sure that you had all the information you needed. So just a big picture about AV Simulation solutions. Okay, so at AV Simulations, we offer three domains. We have the scanner. Scanner is a software suite that enables to run on any architecture, workstation, simulator, real-time target, HPC cloud architecture for massive in-the-loop simulation, and so on. And this is the reason why Scanner can be used all over the vehicle, and I'm going to introduce you further that part and on any architecture. It's the same data, same environment, same model everywhere. We also, at AV Simulation, make simulators, driving simulators. So we have a range of different simulators, I will say, easy simulators up to big simulators on a motion platform with dome at 360 degrees and so on. So if you have any question on that, feel free to ask. And we also offer services at AV Simulation, maintenance services for software, for hardware, training services, consulting services, and engineering services. So should you need to integrate our solution into your ecosystem, feel free to ask. The scanner solutions is used all along the V-cycle by the engineers to test and validate their different models, okay, and system on the test, I will say. So if we focus on that part here today, scanner can be used all along the V-cycle. Usually, you will start with your model in the loop, so you will test and validate your model in the loop thanks to scanner. As we said, scanner can run everywhere. So once you have first stepped your model in the loop, you can build it and start to focus on real-time architecture using the software in the loop solution. Hardware in the loop to test and validate your different hardware. Driver in the loop, of course, we do simulators. And what we will focus on today with Julien and what is at the end, we will see that of the V-cycle is the vehicle in the loop. So scanner is the solution that you can use to decide, verify all your solutions at any step of the V-cycle. And we offer you all the technical features you need inside of Scanner, within Scanner, to test and validate any kind of systems. So if we have a big picture of the Scanner in the loop testing, so I have tried to sum up here what you will have to do. So you will first have to model. So you have access to Scanner simulation platform. Thanks to Scanner simulation platform, you will be able to build rich and representative simulation environment. So you will build roads, you will model your different ego vehicles, you will design your scenario, your test cases, interface your different sensors models, and then once you have built that, the goal of your testing environment will be to connect it to your system under test in order to test and validate your system. With Scanair, you will benefit of a tool that we have more than 20 years of experience. We include a traffic AI, so you don't have to script or it's something that goes quick. Okay, you just drag and drop your different actors on the scene, and then they will behave by themselves. We offer event manager, okay, so you can easily also trigger, create any kind of situations you need. Thanks to our tools, you can also explore parameters for known and unknown situations. We also offer on the shelf NCAP catalog, and as I said, Scanair can run with any kind of architecture simulation platform. So once you have model all of your design, all of your test keys, you have to integrate these with the solution. So we offer you different solutions, okay? So you can use our gateway that gives you access in bidirectional between the simulation environment of Scanair and the system on the test. You filter the data, you communicate with the system on the test. Once you have integrated that, you simulate, all the simulation is running, and then we offer you the tools to analyze all the situations. So that's all that the big picture of the Scanair in the loop testing, how you will test and validate your different systems, how you will integrate it and model the test cases. So let's more focus now on the vehicle in the loop part. So at AV simulation, so here is the big concept, okay, that we have about the vehicle in the loop testing with Scanair. So you have Scanair virtual environment, so you have been prepared your test case based, as I said, on the different test environment, on the different sensors models, on the different ego vehicles you want, different actors and so on. And after that, as I've just shown you, you can create a bidirectional communication with your system on the test. And in that case, this will be the complete production or the prototype of the vehicle. We have experiences in two different use cases, static vehicle in the loop, and this is the one, and thanks to Julien, we will be able to go deeper today. So we have made project with Rotronics with a vehicle in the loop test bench, as you can see on this picture. So it's a static vehicle in the loop here because it does not move, okay? You will see that with Julien, that we have a different engine around the vehicle to test and validate some different components, and we will get back to this today later. And another experience we have is a dynamic vehicle in the loop we made. So here you will mix between the real and the simulation to test and validate subcomponent ADAS systems. And if you have any question on that, it's not something that we will cover today. We had an introduction during the Scanair days, so if you can retrieve it on YouTube, or if you have any question, just feel free to get back to us. So it's augmented reality to test and validate your vehicle in the loop on a test track, but simulating the different actors. All right, so now that he's introduced, I will give you the mic, Julien, and thank you. Thank you.
So thank you, Sylvain. I don't want to bore you with all the history of Rotronics, but we are existing since 1991 and specialize in dyno, means a chassis dyno for motorbike, tractor and car, as well as engine dyno, and now e-motor up to 25,000 RPM. So today we are focusing on the up dyno application. So we are delivering such a system since 2015, and we made more than 20 projects up to now. And as you can see, there is some references on the top from University World to OEM like Valeo, Swedish supercars application at a high level of performance, and also some Chinese institute where we made, on the right, you can see some NVH applications. So this is the main things on this up dyno. First at all, you don't need to have any civil works to prepare to accommodate the dyno. And the dyno is very versatile, considering you can use it as a chassis dyno with a standard road load simulation, or as we will focus on today, control each wheel one by one to trigger a differential if you want, or the transmission, or in our case today, to really simulate the fact that the vehicle is on the road and go to develop the autonomous driving or the ADAS system. So you can please change the slide. So as you can see on the architecture, we have the simulation scanner that is on the right side, and that is linked to the iTest software that is a real-time automation that is managing the dyno at 1 kHz minimum. So the system will exchange the data with the simulation software that most of the time is scanner, but we are also open to other system if some customer wants to use other system, which is not a good news for AV simulation, but that's the life. And so the below this eye test, the system will manage the different hardware. So for sure, a power drive to manage the up to 4 AC motor or PM motor to simulate the right torque and speed at the wheel. We will get by the team EC from HBM the direct torque measurement of each wheel also at 1 kHz. And then, as you can see on the orange rectangle, you can interface a steering rack. You can interface for sure the scanner's software simulation and additional data acquisition as it is plotted on the back it with the Q series from Gantner. If you want to have additional acquisitions coming to this iTest system. For sure, we are also taking care of the CAN communication to the vehicle to exchange the most important data we need to manage efficiently the different test procedure you want to process. So the general requirement is a system that is easily upgradable from a two-wheel drive to a four-wheel drive version. Okay, that is coming completely turnkey, and most of the time we are doing a complete factory acceptance in Rotronics to be sure that what we are delivering is reaching the performances. And in what we are introducing today, because of the most of the time AC motor at the wheel, we have the capability to motor and to also to brake the wheels. Okay, so for the mechanical requirement, this is mobile, so it's easy to handle. So in the low power system, like in case of Valeo, we were in the 60 kW range for light immobility. The system was on swivel caster, but when you reach some very high performance, as we will see after, we have some system based on air cushion where you can move easily the pod, what we call the pod, for a very quick installation by a single operator. So the system, as you can see on the screen, is using some wheel hub adapter. This is generic, so we try to offer one for 4 holes, 5 holes, and 6 holes. Okay, so for each. And we are trying to covering most of the application of a single vehicle OEM. Sometimes you need to have a special one in case your vehicle is very special, but with a 5 holes generics flange adapter, we are capable to cover almost 80% of the European market. So this is already quite good. Most of the time, we are using an inline torque meter from HBM to do a quick and accurate wheel torque measurements. But for some time, for some reason, like some NVH application, it is also possible to have a load cell, because if you are doing mostly steady state application, the load cell is much more affordable and could be enough. I will not focus on that today, but there is, for your information, climatic and NVH models in case you need negative values, temperature values, or NVH application. As far as the power cabinet, most of the application we did were regenerative, so it means that when we are braking the vehicle, whatever it's a thermal or hybrid or electrical vehicle, we are regenerating the power to the grid of the building. Nevertheless, for some special applications, sometimes the university, or if your building is not capable to take this amount of power, we could have some dissipative cabinet that will use a power resistor to allow a high level of break with a limited power coming from the building. As you can see on the green rectangle, it is also possible to have one section of the power drive that is having a DC drive, DC-DC converter, which means that in case of electrical motor, base vehicle, when you are braking at the wheel, we are producing power. We can, if you request that, feed your power drive that is going to the e-motor, and by this way loop the total energy in the truth common DC bus between the AC motor from the dyno and your DC your DC drive. For sure, if needed, we can interface some power meter to get the values and the result and the measurement from this device together in iTest in the test report. You can go to the next slide, please. So, first of all, I told you that the dyno is quite versatile in terms of application. But this is also possible to size the dyno according to the vehicle or to the performance you are expecting. And we have three main level of performance. One is dedicated to city car, typically 48 volts, and we are already applying 1,300 newton meter peak power per axle and 60 kilowatts. What we are considering as an intermediate European vehicle is a 250 kilowatt, 2,200 newton meter per axle. And we offer also a car plus for SUV with a bigger power and a bigger torque available at the wheel. We will come back to that, but in case you are not only developing electrical vehicle and a new energy vehicle. As an example, if you want to simulate a very heartbreaking phase like on the highway from 150 kilometer per hour to zero in a very short time, at this moment, the power we will have to fight is not anymore the power from your powertrain, but the power from your brake pads. So it means that in that case, the system will have the capability to motor the vehicle to fight the brake pads braking torque up to one of the dyno we made up to 1,000 kilowatt and 8,000 newton meter per wheel during a limited time. Okay. Recently, you saw I introduced the fact that we are working with Koenigsegg. So they ask us more than 1,500 kilowatt and 10,000 newton meter per axle that we can reach. So you can just touch the arrow. So what I want to define is that for any project, we will plot together with you what the dyno are capable of in terms of steady state performance as well as transient performance. Because for sure, the e-motor-based solution are capable of a huge amount of torque at low speed, but they are also capable of transient capability that are much more than the similar thermal engine, and the dyno should match that. So it means that in case of the 8,000 newton meter dyno, the standard performance is 3,000 newton meter, but as a peak, we can reach 8,000 newton meter to match your extra power coming from the electrical vehicle. In terms of max speed, 2,800 RPM is the standard, and it's already more than 300 kilometer per hour, so should fit to most of the application. On request, we are able to upgrade the system to up to 4,000 RPM, And another time, you can imagine for what customer it was. To make sure we will not face any mechanical vibration instead of the fact that we don't have a huge steel plate, we have a smart and patented damping system that allow you to drive the car, as you can see on the picture on the top right, without any strap and at the max speed without any issues on the safeties. Why is because the only thing that are rotating and that are where we have some protection guard is the hub, and the mass of the vehicle is at zero speed. Okay, so depending on the size of the dyno, we use a swivel caster to move the dyno or air cushion. What you have in the picture is one big dyno, and is mounted on air cushion. So it means that when you are installing the hub to the car, because this is how it works, you are just removing the wheel, bringing the dyno and connecting it to your hub, and then deinflating the air cushion. Then the dyno is mounted on the on dampers on the floor, and then you can start your test. The total time to install a four-wheel drive, as you can see on the picture, is less than 1 hour. The system is based on HBM torque meter T40, and so we can reach typically from the sensor, not the global mounting, but 0.05% class. On top of that, and we will go back to that later, for the ADAS definition, it is making sense to have a steering simulation that is mounted on the dyno, and I will go back to that on the coming slides. But for your information, we can reach 5,000 newton peak per wheel and a transient time of 100 millimeter per second. You can go to the next slide, please. So, independently of Scanair, the system is managed by a Rotronix application based on the iTest automation, which is a real-time kernel called InTime for Windows. So the kernel basic frequency is 1 kHz, but we can go a little bit faster only for the acquisition. And there is a library of more than 50 communication drivers, including CAN, EtherCAT, Modbus, and most of the protocol that you need to use in the automotive world. Okay, so this is giving you the capability to use your hub dyno out of the simulation application for electrical vehicle distance or development of a powertrain. This is as an example what Valeo is doing. They are doing only powertrain testing on this. So at this moment, the hub dyno is a little bit like an e-axle. You can go to the next slide, please, Sylvain. So what I just introduced to you is what we call the standard mode. And as you can see on the screen on the left, this is at this moment, you can use the dyno exactly as a chassis dyno with a driver head with a predefined speed profile that you will, your operator or your driving robot will follow to make the test efficient and reliable. At this moment, we have a standard mode where the four wheel will be synchronized, okay, which is called the speed control. So we can define, okay, I want to keep my my car at 130 km per hour, or I have a road load simulation where I am inputting exactly the same way than on the chassis dyno, the weight, the drag force, and the slope and the friction. Okay, because it's not like a traditional chassis dyno, we can for sure introduce a virtual steering angle where the effect will be to have the capability to introduce some speed offset between the left and the right. There is something wrong in the slideshow. The left and the right, if you are turning in a curve, So this is the first level of very, very simple simulation. Today, if you are on this webinar, it's because you are focusing on more advanced simulations. So this is what we call the master mode. At this moment, the iTest software that is still operating in the background will exchange all the data with the scanner software based on the 1 kHz UDP communication, and it will open the world to another world where you can drive, or you can let the autonomous driver drive the car on a virtual environment. The car is then receiving the real braking force, and the car is really interacting with the dyno. Sylvain, you can go to the next one, please. So back to this steering simulation. So we decide at Rotronix to not to steer the dyno, but to introduce a real steering simulation. So I told you already that it's a peak 5,000 Newton peak per wheel, and this is much more consistent and could be a model based compared to steering the dyno. It means that depending on the weight, depending on different applications you can have, and also depending on the speed of the maneuver that is in the process, as you can see on the screen, you can see a parking action. You can decide what is the force that the system will apply to the steering rod, and so having more the most consistent behavior behind the steering wheel that you can try. Okay, for sure there is some mechanical interface with the vehicle, so it could require some special parts depending on your vehicle. And as an example, we can have the steering mechanism in front of the wheel axle, or in rear of the wheel axle, depending on your vehicle architecture. Just for information, this wheel steering is this steering concept is available in the iTest Rotronix 100% mode, as well as in the master mode, where the model could come from the scanner. Sylvain, you can go to the next slide, please. Okay, so the first AC motor-based UpDyno that we made, because we made some eddy current version, but it was more for racing application, was in 2015. It was already a complete vehicle, four-wheel drive, and the test bench was already with four independent AC motors, and together with the version of scanner. So you can see there is a Fluence ZD on the dyno, and this Fluence was capable to drive alone on the customer track, and was able to come back to the dyno to make some special tests, as we will see on the next slide. Please, Sylvain. So the application, and this is the testimonial from the customer. This is Johan Bouvet, that is a R&D engineer at the Eudiasic lab that is based in the north of France at the University of Compiègne, that is linked to the French CNRS. He is the head of the simulation program for static VIL, what you can see on the top right, also train platform and the virtual reality, as you can see on the bottom on the left. So on the next slide, now we will see some example of use case, what we call scenario, that they use over the years on this dyno. So they try to see the effect of a failure or of a defective sensor. So what is a defective sensor? It could be some blind spot, some noise, some loss of performances. So on the scanner side, you can define the sensor you are using, but you can also maybe define that this sensor is not always perfect, and see what is the side effect on your on the consistency of the autonomous driver, as an example, or of the ADAS. One of the theses that were taking place at the UTC was a development of what they call a safety bag. So the goal was to try to detect if the main algorithm of the autonomous driver was suffering of a lack of consistency. So one of the scenarios was due to unexpected failure, could be from the sensor, could be from the algorithm. The vehicle is entering a curve faster than expected. So on the map, you are expecting to have a curve that is supposed to be at 60 kilometers per hour, and the autonomous driver is deciding to arriving faster than that, and the effect could be only an accident. So at this moment, they develop a safety bag, and they show by this thesis that the safety bag was a good solution to in some cases release the gas before the curve and keep the steering control to avoid the accident and give back the control to the human driver, considering that most of the time the autonomous driver cannot say, okay, I'm out of business, I cannot do the job anymore, take the control back. It should do that in a safe way, and as well as a time that is considered as 5 seconds for the human driver to take back the control. So this is one of the scenario they developed among thousands. Okay. Another one that was a challenge on the dyno was, and a challenge also for the autonomous driver, was a roadworks on the highway with three lanes that are available to minus one. So what does it mean, minus one? It means that the highway is on your side is completely closed, and you have to go on the opposite way of the highway for a bidirectional flow. Okay, so this one was the dyno was intensively used to be sure that the autonomous driver was capable to handle this kind of tricky situation safely and without giving back the control to the human driver. For sure, detecting a pedestrian, animal, or object on the road and try to take the right decision was also in the scenario they experienced. What should we do? We should avoid it and stay on the road. We should just avoid it. And even if there is a risk of loss of control, plenty of decisions to take that are not easy and that are almost philosophy at one step. So that was one that was some of the application they made on this dyno that was made in 2015. Sylvain, you can go to the next slide. So based on this first feedback of experience, we upgrade in different manner the total system on the Rotronic side as well as on the AV simulation side. So on the Rotronic side, the mechanics, as you can see, was upgraded. So we have stronger dynos. With this peak power of 1,000 kilowatt and 8,000 newton meter per axle. We have a graded automation that is capable of this 1 kilohertz fast communication with the AV simulation scanner. And in the other hand, we upgrade also the steering system for a stronger and faster system. On the scanner side, the system was boosted by some DSpace hardware and the Calas real-time version. And as you can see, this is what we deliver in the last months, a complete four-wheel drive system package with a system that is very easy to install into a dedicated room. Sylvain, Sylvain, next slide, please. So you can start the video. So this is the the car that is on the road and waiting for the traffic light. And so we will the driver will wait and accelerate to pass the traffic light. So then there is no problem to steer, to follow a more complex path and so on. And then this is a AV simulation task to create more landscape, more scenario and so on. And at one moment with the training, you can also be in charge of creating more scenario and landscape. Okay. This is I hope the introduction to the dyno and focusing on the mechanics and the software architecture was interesting for you. And I will let Sylvain conclude on the other slide.
Thank you, Julien. I will get back. So thank you very much. I will get back to the principle of operation and focusing on the last project we made together regarding the Scanner Studio side. If we get back at the beginning of this presentation today, as I said, so thanks to Scanner, you will be able to model all your simulation environment. So in order to feed vehicle in the loop testing, okay, you need a reliable simulation output, and this is what Scanner will offer you. Okay, so you will be able to benefit of all the computations, optical, material, physical of Scanner, advanced computations to feed your different systems. And also thanks to Scanner, you can use at any level of the vCycle the same data running on different architecture. So this is why Scanner is used to test and validate your system on the test at any level of the vCycle. So regarding the project we made, the last project that Julien was talking about, okay, so we had a vehicle in the loop here, the interface. So what we have provided is we have realized the vehicle dynamics model. Okay, so CALAS is AV simulation real-time vehicle dynamic model. It is powered by AV simulation, and we also had an ADAS ECU model. So we prepared the CALAS RT model on our side. Okay, so that was our ego vehicle. We also prepared different sensors model, the test cases to test and validate the systems. After that, we have integrated it. Okay, so the first integration step was on Rotronic side. Okay, to have the four-wheel stock and the steering wheel angle to be provided to the CALAS RT model running, of course, on this space. It's a direct communication way to Scanner simulation environment, text to Scalas, who is Scanner AV simulation. So we receive the vehicle state, and this is why you can control the vehicle. In the other side, we also, of course, it's a bidirectional communication. So we send back information to the dynamic model. It's automatic. And then we send back the four wheel speed and the steering wheel torque to animate the bench, the test bench on the for vehicle, static vehicle in the loop testing. On the other side, we have used our gateway solution to provide the sensors raw outputs to an input output manager in order to feed the ADAS ECU to test and validate the different systems. At the end, so we have simulated everything, and of course we offer you the way with a Scanner after that to analyze. So we have analyzing tools to test and validate everything. So just something to remind you that Scanner has Rotronic solution is an open platform. Okay, so we can work with any kind of solution. Here we've been working with DSpace, we've been working on a vehicle in the loop. You can use a Scanner with any real-time target, with any in the loop solutions. So yeah. So if I try to sum up regarding all we have said today, so a Scanner Studio environment can helps you to go at any level of the vCycle. It is a strength, okay, so you can use the same data, share between different departments, sensors, vehicle dynamic, HMI, headlights, etc. You can use it with any department, same data, same simulation environment, able to run on any kind of platform. Also, as I said, what is important is to run it on different architecture to be able to run all along the vCycle, and this is what we call the digital continuity. So you can run it from a desktop to the test track and using the same software and the same models. It's new. We have so developed Calas RT, who is AV simulation vehicle dynamics model. We have experience on DSpace, Veristance, Concurrent, Red Hawk, okay, running Calas RT on such platform. We have mainly focused today on static vehicle in the loop solutions with Scanner. We also have done, as I said at the beginning, dynamic vehicle in the loop solution. So dynamic will be a mix between real and virtual, so it's augmented reality to leverage your different ECU ADAS to test and validate the vehicle dynamics testing. So this is the summary of this presentation. If you are interested in evaluating Scanner solutions, we offer you a Scanner trial version. It's free on our website. Feel free to ask it. You can just go on our website, go to a Scanner and download the Scanner trial version. We do a weekly workshop, so do not hesitate also to register on our website on the next workshop. We will offer you this video in replay on YouTube in the next days. And so do not hesitate also to visit our webpage. If you have any question, we will have a look to the chat, okay, with Julien, and we will try to do our best to answer. Thank you very much for following, and we will check your different questions.